Greetings, people of Earth. Paul Muckle here again. Today's July 14th, 2011, at 11:08 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now, the image you're looking at, right, was taken on July 13th, 2011, at 4:29 a.m. in the morning, Eastern Time, okay? According to NASA, it's Venus. I don't trust anything that NASA said, but it could be Venus. I'm not going to discount them. But anyway, what I really want to show you guys, people, is that do you see that image around the star? It's a hexagon, people. And it like you have spokes coming out of it. If you look at it real good, people. Now, people, if you all know, NASA discovered a hexagon on the pole of Saturn, right? The hexagon is huge, and the vortex of the hexagon, as you're gonna see, they could fit four Earth inside of it. And people, the hexagon that's on Saturn, it exactly like this hexagon right here around this planet that they call Venus, okay? And my friend, one of my friends asked, I forgot her name, a new friend from Maui, I think. She asked me a question. Are you sure it's Venus? I mean, I don't know. I don't trust anything that NASA say anymore, but this is kind of strange that there's a hexagon, people. It's not even a circle, it's a hexagon. Okay, that's a hexagon around this planet, and you can see the spokes coming out of it. So I'm going to show you what NASA discovered, right? Then after that, I'm going to show you a UFO, people. People, is a UFO in this video, real live UFO. Okay, matter of fact, let me show it to you real quick.
It's been Jupiter. Yeah. Okay, Jupiter.
So this is a UFO right here. Flash across the screen. And I'm gonna show you the video that I took of it. But anyway, like I say, here's Saturn. Here's what NASA discovered, and look at the hexagon around this star and compare it to the one around Saturn, and you see there's something strange going on here. And in the video that I took, people, I talk a lot of junk, okay? Like I said, when I'm speaking to the stars, right, and the sun and the moon, I speak whatever comes to my mind, because that's what they tell me. They said, whatever comes to your mind, speak it. And then later on, sounds out the sense from the nonsense. So, I see a lot of stuff in here, and I'll just speak what came to my mind. So don't think, I'm big-headed, I'm trying to make myself something that I'm not. I just speak what comes to my mind, people. I don't go out there and plan and say, I'm somebody special. I only do it because it comes out my mouth. I don't question my Lord. And my Lord tell me don't question him, because when I question him, I'm gonna feel the punishment of it. So I don't really question my Lord, okay? Unless I know something stupid. So, and nothing he tell me is stupid, but if I think it's stupid, I'm gonna question him, and then I pay the consequences later on. So anyway, I just speak what come out my mouth, people, so don't hate me for it, okay? I'm just a mouthpiece of my Lord. So hear the videos and enjoy. One love. Oh, by the way, right, the person who asked me the question, asked me if I'm sure it's Venus, was Chi-Town UFO. So Chi-Town UFO, sorry, you're the one who asked me if I'm sure it was Venus. I'm not sure if it's Venus. I don't trust anything NASA say anymore. So, like I said, here's the video, and we could probably figure this out together. The people will figure it out, because NASA are gonna lie to us anyway. They're not gonna tell us the truth, so let's try to figure it out, people. What is this hexagon around this star?
In early 2007, modern imaging technology revealed something else on Saturn that astounded scientists.
We see it very, very intensely now.
It's something big, something strange, and something never seen in the universe before. Saturn, the solar system's most bizarre yet beautiful planet, has just gotten even more mysterious. In 1979, the Voyager spacecraft showed a perfect geometric form over the North Pole. In October 2006, the Cassini craft found that it is still there.
It's just bizarre, and it sits there kind of still. It doesn't move the planet. The pole, there's a hexagonal feature, a six-sided polygon that encircles the pole at about 78 degrees north latitude. And it's sitting there as a set feature.
The hexagon is similar to Earth's polar vortex, which has winds blowing in a circular fashion around the pole. Saturn's vortex can fit four Earths inside of it and extends 60 miles deep into Saturn's clouds.
And what's more bizarre, Voyager saw little tiny clouds going around at about 100 meters per second, which is about 200 miles an hour, going around this racetrack. People thought, well, maybe it's just a temporary thing. How could this stay there? It's been there now for at least 20 years, and we're going, what is this?
Hey, people, good morning. Paul McCullough here again. I just woke up. Today is July 13, 2011 at 4:30 a.m. What I want to show you, look at these people. Remember the morning star showed you a couple of weeks ago? It's getting closer, people. Okay, look at that. It is Venus. It's getting bigger, people. And this is the far closest it's been to me so far. Before, it always goes back. But now it's on the move again, people. And the move.
You can see the aurora in certain wavelengths. What's new is that we're up close with Cassini, and that enables us to see details.
So that's the morning star, people.
Cassini camera uses invisible light, so this is the first time we've got really nice images in visible light. I saw those auroras shimmering and changing with time, sort of flickering. And I just like the action. I thought it was beautiful. We're always looking for similarities between planets, especially things that we can compare with Earth. In fact, the auroras on Saturn have a lot of similarities to the auroras on Earth. Both on Earth and on Saturn, you have charged particles.
A Venus.
Out of space.
I just thought of something. Why is Barack Obama using your star as his symbol? Because you're the only star that use the one that retrograde, use the star that orbits backwards. So why does Barack Obama use you as a symbol? Because you lose for the morning star. So Barack Obama must be the morning star then, huh?
Like weather at all altitudes from hurricanes near the ground to...
Yeah, Barack Obama, that's the man, Lucifer, the morning star, okay? But he's not a good morning star. He's the morning star, I want to steal the spotlight.
We're learning
right?
About space weather.
Oh, have you fallen from heaven, Lucifer, son of the morning. So Venus is not even a female. Venus is a male. That's why she's barren. That's why Venus have no life. The guy is a man. Venus is a male. Okay. Lucifer. So why did they call it? I don't know who named it Venus, but His real name is Lucifer. It's a male. Oh, have you fallen from heaven, Lucifer, son of the morning. So all it is that these people, because Venus is the evening star, right? And at times she becomes the morning star. To the Vatican, okay? To the Christians, right? That is the devil falling from heaven. Come on, but how silly can you get? Venus, Lucifer is a star that was the evening star. And when she become the morning star, they claim she fell from heaven. That's the kind of foolishness that these Christians have the people believe in, okay? These popes and these preachers. That's the idiocy they have you believe in. That Lucifer is a devil that fell from heaven. No. It's Venus that was once the evening star and she become the morning star. So to the ancient, she fell from heaven. He fell from heaven. So these Jews, these Rothschilds, okay, these Rothschilds, the Zionist Rothschilds, right, the Rothschild clan, and the Vatican, right, have people fooled. They made gods. They made gods and demons out of these heavenly bodies. They made gods and demons out of them. And gave the people to worship. So now you look at the star, and you're calling it Lucifer and the devil. How do you think this star gonna, what if someone going around calling you a rapist? Right? Or calling you pedophile, or calling you, you know, the most defiled names there is. How would you go about living your life knowing people is calling you that? So these stars, don't you think they have some kind of power? That you're calling them evil, sooner or later they're gonna be evil because we're creators, okay? We create things, okay? If our thought that something is evil, over time, even if it's not evil, it's gonna strike us to make us know, listen, I'm not evil. So anyway, Barack Obama using this star here because he's evil, okay? Man is the one who give these stars their power, you know? Man is the one who give these stars their intention. So when Barack Obama gonna use the star Venus as a symbol, and we know he don't do it in truth and righteousness, so that means he's part of the Illuminati Vatican Rothschild scheme to turn the stars into demons, demons and gods, to use the powers of the stars to fulfill the evil intentions. So Venus, aka Lucifer, is the star that announces that the sun is coming, okay? So people, the sun is the Almighty, and Venus is like the bailiff. All rise, okay? So that's Venus's goal, that's Barack Obama's goal, you know, to tell the world that Paul Merkle is coming. But what he does, he wanna steal my thunder, okay? He wanna steal my inheritance. He want to steal my position, okay? So he trying to destroy me. Same thing that the ancient did, okay? They wanted to steal the power from the sun, so they start worshiping demons. They start worshiping Jupiter, okay? Jupiter and the moon, Jah for Jehovah, because we know Jah, Ra, is the moon, and Hova is for Jupiter, okay? Just like Amen-Ra, so is Jehovah. They just make it one word, but it's not one word, it's two words. Jah, Yah, for the moon, and Hova for Jupiter. So you're worshiping Jupiter's moon. Okay, that's Jehovah, Jupiter's moon. Okay. Moon, Jupiter. Because you gotta know, back in the days, the Egyptians read from left to right.
Sorry, so you see, the Egyptians read from Jehovah, right to left. From right to left, the Egyptians were sorry.
It'll be Hobajah. That means Jupiter moon. Okay? So we're not worshiping Earth moon. We're worshiping Jupiter's moon. That.
Okay, people, I meant to say we're not worshiping Earth's moon. We're worshiping Jupiter's moon, that barren moon. Because, people, if you notice, right? Ever since before March 1st, 2011, the moon that we have had haven't been this size. Okay, it's been a puny little moon. Only sometime when it gets super full and yellow that you could see the details in it. Otherwise, even when the moon is full, all you could see is this round ball without any details. This barrenness. Okay? But ever since March 1st, when the first crescent moon came, it was huge. And then on March 19th, it turned into a super full moon. And ever since then, every month, ever since then, we've been having this super full moon. People, I know it might sound ridiculous to some of you, but heavenly bodies are identical to each other, most of them. Mercury look like our moon. Venus look like Earth. Okay, and a lot of the planets look identical to each other. So my point being, NASA has sprayed so much chemtrail in the air. They have covered the cloud up so much that we don't even know what's going on in the clouds, really. Okay? We don't know what's going on in the sky, but I feel that we have had, and this is a new moon we got. I feel like that. Call me stupid if you want, but if you all can remember, from before March 2011, we were having a barren moon. Now we have this moon look full. It looks like you have a lot of liquid in it, you know, a lot of moisture. You know, it looks like it fertilizes the earth. And that's why there's so much rain in some part of the earth, because the moon is what brings a lot of rain. Mercury brings a lot of moisture. The sun sucks it up, but Mercury also brings moisture. And moons also bring moisture, because moons are associated with harvesting, with spring and crop. So that barren moon wasn't doing its job. It was too far away from Earth, and now it's closer to Earth, so it's not barren anymore. I don't know, call me stupid, but anyway, one love. Okay, hear the rest of the video.
I was being Jupiter. Okay, Jupiter.